Rich in, and we're just about set to kick off. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. He makes it to the 25-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And they push him out around the 30-yard line. To the 40. They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Caught out in the open. And he's tackled at the 49-yard line. That makes it second and two. They make the stop at the 48. He decides to keep it and gets the first down.
Good decision there by the quarterback to hold on to the football and not risk a turnover.
He's at the 40. He gets to about the 34-yard line.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
Decent pickup. From the 30-yard line, second down. There he goes. Gains his way to the 13-yard line.
First down here, Brad, by this offense. The receiver's running the football. You got to think, as a defensive coordinator, it's one thing to try to defend it, kind of your traditional offensive attack. But here you got to start worrying about what is this wide receiver going to do. It puts a lot of pressure on the defense and the defensive mindset on how they want to try to slow this offense down. That makes it second and two. I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He's tackled at the 2-yard line. Taken down at the one. Touchdown, Oregon. He makes the PAT. So a 12-play, 74-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Minnesota's coaching staff so confident, they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country, and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big play ability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big play ability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on their own 28. With the pass, incomplete.
Sometimes when you think you've got great plays called, the defense just has the answer.
He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. And he's tackled at the 36. So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
Gains his way to the 49-yard line. Oregon is up 7. Here's an opening. Brought down at the 39. Got an opening. He's at the 30. Tackled around the 18-yard line.
That's another first down, Brad. Right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Number 17. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. He's got it out to his tight end. He's out of bounds at the 7-yard line.
Guys, I really like what the offensive coordinator is doing here. Throwing it on first and second down, keep the defense guessing.
He might have a chance. Touchdown, Ducks.
Makes this offense so tough to defend. When you have a quarterback with the ability to run and throw and he gets down into this area of the field, chances are he's going to find his way into the end zone.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 5-play, 63-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
So our score, 14-0. He sends this one deep. Looks like they're ready for the kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
They'll drop him for a loss.
The object was to sell the pass and then sneak by the defensive line with the run. The problem here was that the quarterback didn't sell the pass very well.
So it's second and 13. Ball on the 22. He's taken down around the 22-yard line. Him hard at the 14.
Fourth and long here after the sack. He really got a hold of that one. He's taken down at the 49. Oregon's not taking anything for granted. They were supposed to do this, and so far they are doing what they expected to do.
Yeah, they've done a really nice job of just taking care of business. The offense is clicking, quarterback's making good decisions. The defense has been very impressive as well.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. And down he goes at the 36-yard line. We're through one quarter. Oregon's lead is 2 touchdowns. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2. The 37.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
36. Makes the catch and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Pass man open and he dropped it.
Number 23 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and 12.
He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. This one will go into the end zone and they'll bring it out to the 20. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Gets out to around the 28. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Makes it to the 41.
That makes it first and 10.
The misdirection play gets him 4 yards. Second and 5, ball on the 45-yard line. Gets it, he's in space. They'll bring him down at about the 49.
Number 27 brings him down at the 49-yard line. First down.
He gets another carry. And a 6-yard pickup by the halfback on the delay.
That brings him second and 5.
Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 43-yard line. And he is drilled to the 37-yard line. He steps out at the 34. From the 34-yard line, second down.
Second and 7.
gets to about the 24-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. 2 minutes to go in the half. Throws incomplete, knocked away.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. Strong defense to deny the completion.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Almost intercepted there.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
Fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. Kicks up, and he got it. And everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. Brought down at the 20-yard line. The Ducks are just cruising through this first half, Irby. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a 4-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's tackled at about the 21. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Second and 8. Ball on the 21-yard line. Tackled for a loss.
Did you see how that big defensive line got such a good push on that play? That's exactly why they were able to stop him for a loss.
They'll go with a run once again. He's out to the 30. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. Throws it out right to the running back. And they make the stop at about the 37-yard line. Screen gets it to his tailback. He's tackled at the 42. Now he's scrambling. And he's taken down at the 46.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now has really showed a lot of poise, being able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
And he's level at the 34-yard line.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense is putting on him.
Wide receiver screen, and it's dropped incomplete. This is the 9th play of this drive. The Ducks had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. He airs it out. Almost picked off. Tackle made at the 33. Three points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. He sails it long. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. We've still got a half of football remaining. Oregon's in front by 11.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He'll take it from the two. And down he goes at the 26-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Good outside run there. They get about 6 yards on the option to the halfback.
That brings them second and five.
It's second and five here. Ball on their own 32. He's to the 40. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass. As a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, and especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you, and that's what happened. Any offense is predicated on being able to move efficiently like this.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. And that one's going to hit the ground incomplete.
Number 12 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth and six.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. And he's got to be happy with that punt, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, that was nice. So now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score.
They're set to go for another round. It out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down at the 18-yard line.
These short, effective passes are going to help the quarterback's confidence.
Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain. He carries to the 40, the 50, at the 30, to the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Oregon!
Wow. When you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play.
And he hits the PAT. It was a quick three-play, 88-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
So the score now, 21-3, and it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Tackle at the 27. Oregon's coaching staff will go out tonight. I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Tackle right around the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line. First down.
Green nine, go!
He might have a chance. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain 5 yards. That'll make it second and four.
He's at the 40, inside the 30, to the 10, brought down inside the 5. So they pick up big yards on the option keeper.
I thought he's going to break that one for a touchdown. You couldn't draw that up any better.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Taken down at the 3. He's in for the score, and they're back in it.
I think the option down by the goal line is a great call. It puts so much pressure on the defense and allows the quarterback to have the decision to run it or pitch it. And this time it worked to perfection.
He makes the PAT. Golden Gophers running back. He was injured earlier. You see him down there on the sideline, and it looks like he's ready to get back in the game. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 36. Offense lines up in a 5-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play. From their own 31-yard line, second down. Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made at the 42-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
Here we go. Here we go. Watch one.
run, and he's brought down. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. He gets to about the 41-yard line. He's at the 30. He gets to about the 27-yard line. Give to the tailback. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
A good tackling safety is key for any defense. And if they can diagnose a play like this guy can, he can be a real menace.
So at the end of the third quarter, the Ducks lead 21-10. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down at the 18. So the scramble goes for 9 yards. Five wide. He's on the run, and he's going to be sacked.
Great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Kicks away, and the field goal is good. Oregon is lining up to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's taken down at the 25. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line. First down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's pushed out of bounds. The 39-yard line. Tack on any yardage. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Makes it out to about the 23. This one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
On the ground, up the middle. He fights forward to about the 23. From the 23-yard line, it's third down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Under heavy pressure. He's looking for six. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Nine times out of ten, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it. He's to the 40. And they make the stop at around the 50.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
From the 50, it's first down. Makes it out to about the 39.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain in a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
And he's tackled around the 36-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. It's second and seven. Ball on the 36-yard line. He'll get the call again. He's tackled at the 26.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 15-yard line. Taken down at the 3-yard line. Just over a minute left. Touchdown, Ducks. On the extra point. Morgan, kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 21. Minnesota's coaches have got to be scratching their heads right now. They know they have to go back to work and go back to work in a hurry.
Well, the coaches are going to want to go back to work, and the players are not going to want to show up in the film room. They're going to be hiding after this performance. This was embarrassing.
And he tackles him hard at the 27-yard line. Spikes the ball. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. They bring the quarterback down.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
He's at midfield. He makes it out to midfield. Oregon's proven to be the better team in every facet of this football game.
Boy, their defense has played lights out. Their offense is taking advantage of their opportunities. Everything has led them to a very comfortable lead.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Takes a knee. And this one's all but wrapped up. The Ducks take this one, 31-10. Going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.